So before entering inside the topic, let's see about embryology. Bladder extrophy, cloacal extrophy and epispadias are variants of the extrophy epispadias complex. So ye sare congenital abnormalities are the variants of extrophy epispadias complex. And the cause of this complex is due to failure of cloacal membrane to be reinforced by ingrowth of mesoderm. This cloacal membrane develop hone ka time kuch abnormalities or developmental defect aaya to it will results in congenital anomalies. So sabhi log soch rahe cloacal membrane matlab kya hai. Okay, cloacal membrane is nothing but it's a bilaminar layer which is situated at caudal end of the germinal disc that occupies the infraumbilical abdominal wall. So the mesenchymal ingrowth between the ectodermal and the endodermal layers of the cloacal membrane results in the formation of lower abdominal muscles and the pelvic bones. Means it will be this ectodermal and the endodermal layers of the cloacal membrane only finally develop into lower abdominal muscles and pelvic bones. So agar isme premature rupture or kuch developmental defect or it infraumbilical defect hoga to it will be results in bladder extrophy or cloacal extrophy or epispadias. So normally after the mesenchymal ingrowth kya hoga matlab the urorectal septum grows in a caudal direction and it divides the cloaca into bladder anteriorly and the rectum posteriorly. So this urorectal septum caudal direction pe caudal means head to tail. So upar se niche it will be growing. And this cloaca divides into two. Matlab ek upper part bladder form hoga, niche ka part rectum form hoga. Okay, distally the septum meets the posterior remnant of the bilaminar membrane which eventually perforates and forms the urogenital and anal opening. So the paired genital tubercles migrate medially and fuse in the midline and cephala to the dorsal membrane before perforation. In this picture you can see the cloacal membrane, how it is first it is fused and second peak slowly it is dividing. That means egg side it is going genitourinary and the other side digestive tract, that means intestinal part. Then in third peak size 12 mm, so in approximately open developed, and in the fourth step or fourth peak it is developed into proper urogenital tract and anal region. That means two opening, urethral opening and the anal opening is properly developed. Okay, these are about embryology of this bladder and the rectal development. Next, let's see about condition extrophy of bladder. So bladder extrophy is a rare congenital genitourinary malformation with complex birth defect due to improper fusion of abdominal wall and underlying organs during the fetal period. So during the pregnancy time, cloacal membrane properly fused nahi hua to this developmental defect occur. Okay, so it is usually associated with number of congenital anomalies which may be related to urogenital tract, musculoskeletal system and sometimes GI tract also. So it refers to aversion of the bladder to the outside of the body. So here in this condition bladder body ke bahar dikhega. Okay, so it is also termed as ectopia vesicae, that that is malposition or misdisplacement of urinary bladder from its normal position in the pelvis. So incidents, male children are more commonly affected. So while comparing females, males jada affected and the ratio is 2:1. Though males affected to ek female affected. So and age, this one is reported in twins. So jada cases twin babies ko reported abhi tak. And a higher incidence of bladder extrophy is observed in infants of younger mothers and in those with relatively high parity. So the higher incidence young mothers, that means teenage pregnancy or early motherhood, for them the baby will be having extrophy of bladder, and higher parity, those who are having more number of children, unko bhi chances jada hai. Next, etiology, it is idiopathic, matlab unknown cause, and other thing, genetic predisposition. Agar genetic disorders hai to uske saath aane ka chances hai. And abnormalities in the cloacal development. This cloaca formation ka time, kuch abnormalities hua to usko bhi chance jada hai. Next, maternal tobacco exposure. During the pregnancy time, if the mother is exposed to tobacco use, okay, so then the baby may be jada chance for affecting. Next, in vitro fertilization, that means IVF pregnancy, like test tube babies, so there also chances are high. Next, classification. First is classic bladder extrophy, and the second is cloacal extrophy. So classic bladder extrophy means the only the bladder, it will be outside, that means other parts, the rectal, anus, everything will be proper, but it is the defect in lower abdominal wall, bladder, genitalia, pelvic bones, rectum and anus. So here what happened? The bladder mucosa with urine dripping continuously, urinary incontinence will be there. So in this pic you can see the classic bladder extrophy. First one is male baby with classic bladder extrophy, and the second is female baby with classic bladder extrophy. Next, cloacal extrophy. So it's the most severe defect. It may not urethra, bladder, bowel. It will be present outside, and in this condition, GI tract involvement will be there and central nervous system will be also involved. And it is very rare condition. It occurs 1 in 2 lakhs to 4 lakhs live birth. So in this pic, you can see cloacal extrophy. Next, pathophysiology. So humne dekha the mesodermal ingrowth between the ectodermal and the endodermal layers of the bilaminar cloacal membrane result in the formation of lower abdominal musculature and pelvic bones. So this develop hone ka time kuch abnormalities or this issues will be occurring. So tab kya hoga? Defect होने का chances है. Actually, it will, the mesenchymal ingrowth occurs and the downward growth of the rectal septum divides the cloaca into bladder anteriorly and rectum posteriorly. So the genital tubercles migrate medially and fuse in the midline cephal to the dorsal membrane before it perforates. So premature rupture occurs, and उसके बाद इट विल बी रिजल्ट्स इन ब्लैडर एक्सट्रोफी, क्लोएकल एक्सट्रोफी और एपिस्पैडियास. नेक्स्ट, क्लिनिकल मैनिफेस्टेशन. सो हियर एब्सेंस ऑफ एंटीरियर अबडोमिनल वॉल विल बी देयर. उसके बाद यूरिनरी इनकॉन्टिनेंस, दैट मींस ड्रिपलिंग ऑफ द यूरिन, देन कॉन्स्टेंट ऑर्डर ऑफ यूरिन एंड एक्सकोरिएशन ऑफ सराउंडिंग स्किन, क्योंकि कंटिन्यूसली ड्रिपलिंग ऑफ यूरिन विल बी देयर, उसके वजह से क्या होगा, स्किन विल बी मॉइस्ट, इट विल बी लीड्स टू दिस इरिटेबिलिटी एंड स्किन डैमेज होने का चांसेस ज़्यादा है. देन मेल चाइल्ड है तो समटाइम्स इट विल बी एसोसिएटेड विथ एपिस्पैडियस, शॉर्ट पीनिस, अनडिसेंडेड टेस्टिस और इनग्वेनल हर्निया. फीमेल चाइल्ड मीन्स बाइफिड क्लाइटोरिस विल बी देयर एंड मिसिंग रूफ ऑफ यूरिथ्रा विल बी देयर. नेक्स्ट प्यूबिक बोन्स एंड रेक्टस मसल्स आर वाइडली सेपरेटेड. एनस इज placed anteriorly and umbilicus is pushed downwards. Next, waddling gait due to external rotation of femoral head will be there. Next, diagnosis. So, prenatal diagnosis of bladder extrophy. So, it is inability to visualize the bladder on ultrasound. Then, lower abdominal bulge will be there. Then, small penis or with anteriorly displaced scrotum will be there. Then low set umbilical insertion, abdominal widening of the iliac crest will be there. Then management, surgical reconstruction. So first urogenital defects ko correct karna hai. Next renal function, if it is going on properly wo evaluate karna hai. Next functional and cosmetically acceptable external genitalia and maximize the patient quality of life. Next, complete primary repair of extrophy. So reconstructive surgery should be done. That means first bladder ko close karna hai, then bladder neck, kyunki sphincter control nahi hoga to bladder control it won't be there. So uske liye bladder रिकन्स्ट्रक्शन, देन अगर एपिस्पेडियस है तो उसको रिपेयर करना है. फाइनली क्लोजिंग द पेल्विक बोन्स, दैट मीन्स पेल्विक एस्टियोटॉमी. नेक्स्ट इनिशियल रिकन्स्ट्रक्शन इज टू कन्वर्ट द एक्सट्रोफिक ब्लैडर टू अ कंप्लीट एपिस्पेडियस. देन पेल्विक ऑस्टमीज, अगर पेल्विक बोन्स और प्रॉपर नहीं है तो उसको ओपन करके रिपेयर करना है. Epispadias, it should be done 6 to 12 months of age, and the bladder neck repairs is performed at 4 to 5 years, kyunki by 3 years only bladder control will be there attained. So uske baad humko maloom hai bladder neck control attained or not, so uske baad surgery karna hai. In this pic aapko the first incision to mid shaft of penis they are doing, then incision down to vagina loss. Okay, next incision follows bladder template and incorporates umbilicus, then lateral aspect of bladder resected, then they will be connecting properly. Next, nursing management. As a nurse hum kya kya karna hai, first maintain intake output chart, then monitor the signs of UTI and urine wound infection, then skin integrity, kyunki bladder exposed mucosal layer and the exposed bladder mucosa will be there, so integrity maintain karna hai. Next, prevent the bladder tissue from drying, uske liye means until the closure, surgical closure, like some gauze or something, wet gauze should be covered with that. It should be sterile, non-adherent, clear plastic wrap or sterile thin film dressing without adhesive. Next, petroleum jellies should be avoided, kyunki it will be damage the bladder mucosa, isliye petroleum jelly should be avoided. Next, agar child is prone to UTI, matlab antibiotics administer karna hai as per the doctor's prescription. Next, emotional support, kyunki hospitalization and they will be mentally upset, so emotional support should be given to the parents, and they agar un parents or caretakers ko kuch doubt hai to वो फ्रीडम देना है क्वेश्चन पूछने के लिए. एंड कॉम्प्लिकेशन डिसेंस ऑफ द वुंड एंड द ब्लैडर, देन ब्लैडर प्रोलैप्स होने का चांस ज़्यादा है. नेक्स्ट डेवलपमेंट ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर और आउटलेट अब्स्ट्रक्शन. एंड सर्जरी के बाद वुंड इन्फेक्शन होने का चांसेस है UTI, देन पीनल सॉफ्ट इंजुरी विथ सम मेथड्स ऑफ रिपेयर. ओके देन फाइनली नर्सिंग डायग्नोसिस, इम्पैर्ड यूरिनरी एलिमिनेशन रिलेटेड टू इनकॉन्टिनेंस ऑफ यूरिन फ्रॉम अबनॉर्मल यूरिट्रल आउटलेट्स, देन डिस्टर्ब बॉडी इमेज रिलेटेड टू डिसीज कंडीशन, रिस्क फॉर इन्फेक्शन रिलेटेड टू डिफेक्ट इन एंटीरियर अबडोमिनल वॉल, इम्पैक्ट स्किन इंटेग्रिटी रिलेटेड टू सर्जिकल ट्रामा, एंग्जायटी रिलेटेड टू थ्रेट टू सेल्फ कॉन्सेप्ट, चेंज इन हेल्थ स्टेटस एंड एनवायरनमेंट. सो अभी तक हम एक्सट्रॉफी ऑफ ब्लैडर के बारे में डिस्कस किया. सो आई थिंक एवरीवन अंडरस्टैंड द टॉपिक. सो थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग.